Namaste students. So last class we studied about database management system, databases and the different operations on the database and different terms etc. And here terms related to the databases are, it's already in last class it is already explained. So there is first one is file. So file means it's a basic unit of storage. A file is a basic unit of storage, or we can say it's a collection of, I mean large collection of related elements. And then table. So what do you mean by a table? See, table means it's a collection of elements in terms of rows and columns. See, table is a term used in RDBMS. Actually it's one of the database management system, RDBMS. So table is a collection of logical elements. Actually that can be explained in terms of rows and columns. And next one is records. So what do you mean by record? Actually record in any table, normally record that we can see, we can see that one in table, actually it's a all the information regarding to a particular entity, or we can say an horizontal row in a table is called a record. An horizontal row in a table is called a record. And next next term is tuple. Tuples. Tuple is also the same to the record. An horizontal row in a table is called tuple. Next, fields. And fields also, we can say fields are also called as attributes, or we can say properties. So distinct column headers in a table, distinct column headers in a table is called fields. So we can represent like this, column headers. For example, we can consider this is a table, and here column headers are called as fields. Fields, or we can say attributes. Next one is domains. So what do you mean by a domain? See, domain means set of values, that is regarding to a single column, set of values, or we can say range of values that can be range of values in a column or in a particular attribute is called as domains. And next one is entity. Normally entity is an object. Entity is an object, and that defines the relationship between elements or in relational database. Okay, these are about different database terms, in our syllabus. And next concept is data types of database. Data types of database, or data types in database. So what are the data types? Here there are some data types. Here first one is integer. See, integer is a data type that includes whole number without fractional part. So that includes whole number without fractional part is called as integer data type. And here that includes only digits or numbers. It includes digits or numbers. Next one is single and double precision. See, single and double precision, there are 7 numbers that we can include, or 7 digits we can include. A single and double precision, that is to specify the fractional part. Single and double precision. And the next, third data types in databases, logical data type. So logical data type, here it is used to represent one of two values, either true or false, or we can say it is to represent 1 or 0. And the next data type is characters. See, character data type is used to represent some characters. It may be alphanumeric, it may include alphabets, or it may include digits, or any other special characters also allowed in characters data type. Okay, next data type is strings. See, strings means collection of characters, or we can say sequence of characters. Here we can specify static or fixed length. So that includes 0 to 63 kilobyte. 0 to 63 kilobytes. Static means fixed length, and other one is dynamic. Dynamic means it uses different lengths. And here it includes 0 to 2 billion characters. 0 to 2 billion characters. These are about string data type. And other one is memo data type. Actually, memo data type, it is to represent some strings or characters, set of characters. And here it uses 255 characters. So we can use 255 characters. That means we can include some default statements in this case. Default statements, it is called as memo data type. And next one is index field. See, according to index field, normally it includes its data also. Index field includes relevant information along with some comments or data. That means we can represent like this. See, consider this table. And in this table, we can have some index values. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4. And it is associated with some comments or some data. Or some document also allowed. So in this case, document, data or document, any other information. Okay, these are about index fields. And eighth one is currency field. And by default, database concept, by default, it uses dollar as currency, currency field. So in latest databases, it uses rupees and dollars also allowed, and sometimes pound, etc. So different types of currency fields are allowed, or currencies are allowed under currency field. Next, ninth data type is date field. So date field, that is to indicate the date. So here in date data field, it uses DD, MM, YY, YY format, or MM, DD, YY, YY format. So according to American, and here it uses MMDD YYYY format, or in India we are using DD MM YYYY format. And last one is text field, and here text field is used to represent some alphanumeric characters. Alphanumeric characters means it may include lowercase a to z, uppercase a to z, and it may use 0 to 9 digits and special characters also allowed under text fields. Okay, students, next we will move on to this one, database management system. So what do you mean by database management system? We know that database is a collection of logically related data items or data elements. Database management system means it's a software that allows us or allows the user to create, define and manipulate data. So DBMS, database management system, is a software that allows the user to create, define and manipulate the data. So that means it provides its own application program to perform some operations on the data. So database, we know that so far database is a collection of logically related data items, and here what happens is it provides some software to handle such data. It is called as database management system. See, there are some databases and their vendors. That means those who have designed such database. Here, first database is SQL Server, and it is designed by Microsoft. Next database is Oracle, and it is designed by Oracle itself. And DB2, database 2, is designed by IBM company. Next, MySQL, Oracle, and Sybase, designed by SAP. So, main purpose of designing database management system, that is to avoid the data duplication, or we can say data redundancy. And one more thing is, it should follow, or it should provide some secure software, or it should follow some, it should provide some security to the data. That means whenever we are going to access such data or items, data items, and it should not affect the other things or other database or other data constraints. Okay, these are about database management system. Next one is features of database system. So what are the features of database system? Whenever you are going to design a database, we should consider, or we should keep in our mind that it should follow some integrity. And main thing is here, centralized data management. In any database, centralized data management means almost all the data that should be stored in the centralized machine or center machine. In such a way that, for example, if you are using a machine like this, the central machine, and it is connected to any other workstation or nodes like this, and what happens is here user 1 or node 1, node 2, node 3, node 4, here data and instructions are stored in this computer. central computer, and it is also, we can say that it is server, and all other nodes are treated as the clients, server and client. So centralized data management means all the data and instructions are stored in this server. Suppose this particular user N1, those who are sitting in this node 1 PC, can access the data from the server itself, and he can manipulate some things on the particular data. That means he should be provided with some permission, then only he can change the contents, or he can do whatever he want. Okay, these are about centralized data management, and centralized data management, it provides security to its user in such a way that not all the user can have all the permissions. So only few user can use some permissions, and according to that they can perform their own operations. And next one is controlled data redundancy. Controlled data redundancy is a second feature, and here in this case, controlled data redundancy, that indicates elimination of duplicate data items. Elimination of duplicate data items. Just because of this one, centralized data management, it will not allow the duplicate items or duplicate data or duplicate entity. See, for example, if you are using student information database, so what happens is student name and all those things are there, address and his roll number and all those things are there. And here, node 1, he is to send the student information, and student information also include course details. Here node 2, those who are sitting in node 2 can upload this one, course details, and then, and here what happens is, and he is going to send student name, for example, Rana N. And here, whenever he is going to upload the things, he is going to upload the course details, and here also he may use the Rana N. Instead of Rana N, he may use lowercase n. So what happens is, it will keep the both the copies of Rana N, and first one is designed or uploaded by N1, and second one is uploaded by N2, and what happens is automatically duplicate items that will be in that particular database. So here what happens is, we should, that particular database, it should control the data redundancy. So that is the main point. Redundancy means avoiding the duplication of that particular data items. So that's the second point. And third one is enforcing data integrity. See, enforcing data integrity means, and here what happens is, just because of data redundancy, automatically data integrity will happen. That means integrity means validity of data. Validity of data, it is called as data integrity, and because of this one, data redundancy, automatically it happens, or we are going to enforce that one as data integrity. So this is the third point. Next one is, next feature of database is data sharing. So main purpose of database management system is to share the data. So once you are going to store the data in server or central computer, so that one automatically shareable to all other nodes, N1, N2, N3, N4. So that's about data sharing. And here, that means database administrator or server can provide some permissions to the user, which one is allowed and which one is not allowed. So that is the fourth point, data sharing. And fifth one is ease of application development. So what do you mean by ease of application development? That means application program, it provides some options or tools to operate on that particular data. So it is called as ease of application development or application development. That means we can create our own application to perform some operations on database. See, database itself is a collection of some data, and to handle such data, to operate such data, we need application program. So that's why we can say database management system includes data plus some application program. So fifth point is ease of application development, and sixth one is data security. So because of we are using centralized system or centralized data management, automatically it provides some data security. So what do you mean by data security? And here what happens is whenever you are going to use such a database or database management system, so there may be the chance of deleting some data items. To avoid such deleting data items, we can apply this one, data security. Actually, it's very easy to implement data security to the centralized data management or centralized system. If our system, database system, if it is centralized, then it is very easy to handle such problems. Next one is multiple user interface. Multiple user interface means multi-user. Here, by using client server network, here multi-user can use such items. So what happens is, here is a centralized system or server, and here many user can use the particular data. And one more thing is, whenever you are going to implement multiple user interface, we should provide some permissions to the user. An end user or a user, and he has to allow to use some particular modules only, not all the modules. Module 1, module 2, module 3, in such a way that we can assign the work to the users. So more than one work can simultaneously, that means we can use multitasking. And next one is backup and recovery. And another most important feature is, the feature of database system is backup and recovery. So what is the purpose of using backup? So whenever, if our system is undergo crash, so what happens is we need backup copy. Backup copy means, in such situation, we can make use of such backup copies. And thus we can get the recovery also. Okay, these are about features of database system. Okay, next concept on database concept is, why a spreadsheet is not a database? We know that spreadsheet, so under Windows or Microsoft Office Automation, spreadsheet application is Excel. And here what happens is, here by using spreadsheet application or Excel, we can create our own table, we can perform operations on that table, and we can mention or highlight a particular cell. But thing is, there is self-documentation is not there. That means, for example, we have a data in any information. For example, we can have a cell like this, it's of general, and we can insert some information 15, and data about data, that means metadata, is not available in spreadsheet application. And one more thing is, whenever you're going to store the data by using spreadsheet application, and large amount of data, for example voter ID or voter details of our citizens of India, and what happens is automatically that data that will be overlapped. That means whenever accessing such data, whenever accessing using such tools or data, and what happens is that data will be overlapped. So it's not possible to get such data items just because of this one. Metadata is not there. So what do you mean by metadata? Metadata means data about data. That is called as metadata. Metadata means data about data or information about a particular data. It is called as metadata. Okay, so this is the reason, that means it's not possible to use a spreadsheet or Excel as a database. Okay, next we'll move on to this one, data abstraction. So far we know that object-oriented programming, so what do you mean by abstraction? Abstraction is nothing but representing essential features of an entity, of an object, without representing actual details or without representing background details. It is called as data abstraction. Actually, according to this concept, data abstraction, that explains internal or architecture of that particular database. Architecture of database. So what do you mean by architecture? So how it works? So how data actually is stored in a particular database? See, there are three levels of database abstraction. So first one is internal level, conceptual level, and external level. So what do you mean by internal level? See, internal level is also called as physical level, or we can say internal schema. And here what happens is, it represents how data actually stored in a secondary storage device or in any other storage device. How data actually stored in a secondary storage device. And Here, in this case, internal logger that is responsible to store the data in a hard disk or any other storage device. Okay, these are about internal logger. Actually, internal logger, it is near to the physical medium or physical device. Near to the physical medium or physical device. Next one is conceptual schema. So, what do you mean by conceptual schema? So, normally conceptual schema is also called as logical logger. Logical level. Actually, we are not able to get the actual how data stored in hard disk, but it provides some logical schema or logical definition how data can be stored and what are the relationship between the data, and it establishes some relationship between the data, how data is related to another information, how we can access such data, how it is possible to we can implement some operations on that data. So these are all information depending on this conceptual level. So internal level is over, conceptual level is also over, internal level or internal schema is also called as physical level or physical schema. And second one is conceptual level that represents, so what are the relationship between the data, so what are the types of data, so how it is pointed or connected one data to another. So all those informations are specified by this particular level or conceptual schema. And conceptual schema that acts as an interface between external view and internal view or external level and internal level. That means it does not give any explanation about the data, how it is stored, actually stored in a secondary storage device, but it gives, it establishes link how one data is connected to another or how one data linked to another, and such informations are available in conceptual level. And third one is external level, and it is also called as view level, external level. Actually, external level and this type of information provided to the end user. End user means normally end users are, we can say, data operators, and they are going to provide the information to the system, or information which is not so important considered to DBA or any other database users. And here he is provided with, that end user provided with certain information, not whole. That means he has to perform some operations on the module, particular module, not whole system, right? Okay, these are about different types of data abstraction. Just go through this one, data abstraction. Here external schema or external level, and here view 1, view 2, view 3, etc. These views are called as end users. That means each and every end user, he is responsible to his module only, not all the modules. That means he is provided with some permission only. For example, if you are facing with the student information database, actually student information database may include course details, subject teachers, details of subject teachers and fee structures, etc. And one end user is allowed to or allocated to put the information of a particular student. That means his academic information only, and that user or that particular view cannot access the course details of that particular student. That means he is allowed to work with this particular information only. That means student information, that means academic information only he can access, or he can modify the things. Okay, these are about external level. And here conceptual schema and internal schema, and last one is database. See, here linkage between external view and conceptual view is depend on the logical independence, or we can say mapping between external and conceptual is logical. And here linkage between conceptual and internal schema is physical independence. See, data independence means we know that there are different schemas, and we are going to define or change the schema of one particular level without affecting the other levels.
Here, if you are going to change the contents of conceptual schema, and what happens is it should not affect the data in this particular view and here also. So it should not affect the schema, external schema or internal schema.
Okay, these are about data abstraction, and here data abstraction means representing the essential features without including background details. And this question, that means what do you mean by data abstraction, you can expect for final examination, and this is for the 5 marks. So question may ask like this: so what do you mean by data abstraction? Explain the different levels of data abstraction.